Hi, I'm Ian Small, CEO of Evernote, and I'm here with Chris, one of the members of our engineering team who's working on the note editor. And one of the things that Chris has been working on is what happens when we copy and paste information in from the outside world, because it can be a bit tricky. What kind of problems do users run into?
Yeah, well, it turns out when you copy something, there's two different things you could mean by that. You could mean, I want to copy this over and make it look exactly like what I copied, or you could mean, I want to take all of this content and put it into the editor so that I can manipulate it.
So sometimes what it looks like is not the same as all the content that's underneath it.
Yes, and this is actually really common, especially on the web. There's a lot of tricks that web developers use in order to hide information or in order to get the presentation just right.
So what are we doing to let the user tell us what they want?
Yes, so I've got an example here. I've got a website, and I'm just going to copy some content here into Evernote. So copy this, and then paste it over in the editor.
Huh. And immediately we can see it looks pretty different. Over here, I can see four pictures, whereas on the left, I just see sort of the single picture. Are these pictures over here what's behind this?
Yes, exactly. So when we paste, we actually put two things into Evernote. We put the content as it appears, and then we automatically run it through a simplification process where we're taking out all the content and we're making it all editable.
So I see as you went through it, I saw the pictures, I saw these little thumbnails, which is down here, mm-hmm. and then I see as you scroll down, we get all the detailed imagery here, all the detailed text in this part.
Exactly.
So, but if what I want is a version that looks more like this, can I do that?
Yes, so when we put it in there, we paste it in there and then we automatically simplify it. So if you want to get back, you can just use Command-Z to undo, and you get a representation of the content that looks a lot closer to the source.
Immediately, it looks a lot more visually similar. I can now see that that is actually, you know, a visual copy of what I've got over here on the left. But now am I stuck? I can't actually get back to the other version? I mean, it looks pretty, but actually I do want to go and copy and paste some of this. What do I do to get back?
Right. So you can still select content in here and interact with it in a sort of read-only mode. Mm-hmm. But if you do want to edit it, you can go up here, and we have the Simplify and Make Editable command. And this breaks out all the content and represents it in a way that is consistent and can be edited in a reliable way.
So as the user, I get to make the choice. Do I want the version that's got all the content and I can edit to my heart's content? Or do I want the version that looks more like the place that I copied it from?
Yes, exactly.
Can we look at some other examples?
Yes. So we can go over to here. I've got an article comparing some alternatives. And so I'm just going to copy all of this content, this whole article, into Evernote. So a very long article. And when I paste it, again, I get the full representation, but then I also get the simplified form that has all the content broken out. So let's go to the same place on the page.
Yeah, so what does this look like? So I see when we look at these two tables, immediately there are some differences. Over here on the left, I've got the images and I've got the names of the vacuum cleaners. On the right, it looks like I've got the images, the web links that were behind it, and the names.
Yes, so on the left side, we had the images and the links were the same thing. And on the right, we want to make this editable in a way that's consistent with the rest of the Evernote editing experience. So we've broken them out so you can edit the links separately from the images.
And the same thing has happened down here at the read review line.
Yes, so we have the link and then we have the image separate.
So this is in a table at this point. Am I free to sort of edit this table as I see fit?
Yes. In this mode, everything's editable. So I can do whatever I would like. I could add columns. I could add rows with my own comments in here.
And ultimately, if I want to get back to this view, I can.
Definitely. So I'm just going to undo a few times. And then we'll get back to the representation that is a close copy of what we're seeing.
I see, yeah, it looks really good. Are these now hot, just like these are? They're all hyperlinks?
Yeah, so when it's in this container, it behaves almost exactly like it would on a website. So I can hover over these, and I can actually follow through the links and go to the web page.
Maybe you should buy an iLife A6.
Maybe. I at least want to peel the plastic off.
That's pretty good. So everything we've been talking about so far is about copying and pasting HTML content. But we have a web clipper, so how does that work?
Yes, so the web clipper is really great because it helps tame complex articles like this, where we've got a lot of extra information, but I probably don't care about most of that. And so the clipper can help us focus in on exactly what we care about.
I see. So it's going to zoom in automatically the stuff that's important, this stuff in the green.
Yep. And we can go ahead and clip that.
And now at this point, it's saving the clip. It's going to sync it up to the cloud. And then we're going to sync it back down to Evernote on the other side.
Exactly.
Okay. So it's synced across to the editor. So what I notice here is before when we were looking at these containers, it said HTML content at the top. Now it says web clip. Why is it different?
We want to have a better interaction between the web clipper and the editor. And so as a start, we're just identifying content that comes from the web clipper. But eventually, we might be able to do more interesting things.
And knowing that it comes from the web clipper, does that help us in some way?
We could determine what the source website was or what type of clip it was. We might be able to do interesting things there. This is part of why we're rebuilding the editors. We want more than just fixing bugs and making it more stable, although that is a big part of it. We also want to be able to develop new features and have more interesting interactions with your content available in the editor.
That's fantastic. Well, thanks very much, Chris, for talking to us a little bit about the ins and outs of copying and pasting into the new editor and what the new editor is going to make possible, the best of both worlds, essentially.
Yes.
And thanks for joining us as we're walking through some of these changes we're making to the Note editor. We hope you'll join us next time behind the scenes at Evernote.